Hey everybody, it's Kim again, and welcome to the second video explaining how to use the guides in Storyboard Pro. In this video, we're going to be looking specifically at the two-point perspective guide. So in my scene, I have my guides open. You open them by pressing this plus button, by your tabs, and selecting your guides. And I specifically want my two-point perspective guide, so I drop down on my plus button over here and select two-point perspective and make sure that it's selected. Then you'll see all of your options and you'll be able to see the grid if you have one of your drawing tools selected. So here we have our two-point perspective. I've already edited mine because I've done a rough scene. You can see my horizon line is quite high up and my vanishing points are quite far out. Again, you can move these points by having your guides unlocked, which is the default, and grabbing them and moving them where you need them to be. And then when you're happy, you can just go lock your guides by pressing this lock guide button. Don't forget to have this button selected if you want your lines to follow the perspective guides. So in this scene, I'm going to be drawing a little staircase scene that I've actually pre-planned. As you can see, we have a nice two-point perspective happening here where we have two diagonals that we can work with. Whereas in the one-point perspective, we only had the one diagonal coming towards us. So I'm going to neaten this up. I'm going to turn on my light table so that I can see nicely. And once again, while you're drawing, you can use your left and right keyboard buttons to select the specific line that you want to draw to. As you can see, it's highlighting the different dotted lines, which means that my pencil tool will only draw to that line. Also, if you'd like to turn your guides on and off using a shortcut key, you can use G. And G will turn them on and off for you automatically. So I'm just going to neaten up the scene using my two-point perspective guides so you guys can see what you can achieve with the two-point perspective. And there we have just a little scene with a staircase and some paintings and some portraits of people, all done with the two-point perspective tool.